I'm Karen Dubinsky. I teach here at Queens, and I'm really happy to welcome Alex Cuba to Kingston, to Queens, and to the Grad Club.
Thank you, Karen. I'm very, very happy to get to speak with you here today.
So Alex is here because he's going to give a concert, but he's here in Kingston because he received an honorary degree from Queen's University for many years of and multiple contributions to Canadian culture, to Canadian music. Specifically, this is not the first honor that Alex has ever received, and it's certainly not the first honor he's received this year. He, along with his Grammy, Latin Grammy awards and his Juno awards, he won a Grammy itself this year. And so this all makes me wonder what it feels like after so many years of working on your craft. You're getting a lot of recognition. You've always got recognition and you've always been productive, but you're getting the Grammy must have felt really special. What's that been like?
I'm telling myself that it doesn't have anything to do with age. How it feels? Feels like I'm getting old. No. I mean, it feels that, and it's becoming quite clear to me, you know, that if you have a vision, if you feel something and you're able to maintain it and do your part, which is most of the time a lot of work, a lot of perseverance, a lot of hard work, sacrifice, which is what has been my case, living so far away from everything, living in Smithers, BC, in the mountains of British Columbia. Lots of Cubans up there, right? Just kidding. It feels that my vision is finding its place in the world. And my vision was from the beginning to create this type of music. And that first, the vision came to me this way. Something told me at the beginning when I first came to Canada, beauty is universal. Mm-hmm. And is capable of going above language. If you are capable of creating a beauty, something beautiful, that is beautiful because it comes from your heart. So it feels in a lot of ways that this music, which for me is due to that vision, the fusion of a mango seed with an apple seed, let's just put it that way, is finally getting to be acknowledged, you know, and recognized throughout the world. So it's been an amazing year. I can't tell you how exciting this year has been, you know. Hey, everybody. I'm going to sing a song entitled Si, Pero No. This is one of my biggest hits. Let's do it. El silencio me agita, me rompe la calma. Una fiebre vaguita se convierte en ansias de zafar el nudo que llevo en el alma desde que la he visto enamorada. Sí, pero no, porque yo sé que en su amor no me conviene, no. Pero sí, que puede ser mejor que lo que ella tiene, sí. Pero no, porque yo sé que en su amor no me conviene, no. Pero sí, que puede ser mejor que lo que ya tienes. Si al mirarte miraras, yo sería un espejo y quizás te engañara al reflejar tu cuerpo. Ahí harías la prisa devorando el tiempo dentro de mis ojos lo que siento. Ay, harías la prisa devorando el tiempo dentro de mis ojos lo que siento. Dentro de mis ojos lo que yo siento. Sí, pero no, porque yo sé que en su amor no me conviene, no. Pero sí, que
puede ser mejor que lo que ya tiene, sí, pero no, porque yo sé que su amor no me conviene, no, pero sí, que puede ser mejor que lo que ya tienes. Como un abismo me he perdido en esta situación, se apodera de mí y no me deja decidir. La vida lo dirá, la vida lo dirá. Sí, pero no, porque yo sé que su amor no me conviene, no, pero sí, que puede ser mejor que lo que ella tiene, sí, pero no, porque yo sé que su amor no me conviene, no, pero sí, que puede ser mejor que lo que ella tiene, sí, pero no, porque yo sé que su amor no me conviene, no, pero sí, que puede ser mejor que lo que ella tiene, sí, pero no, porque yo sé que su amor no me conviene, no, pero sí, que puede ser mejor que lo que ella tiene, sí, pero no.
You said some really beautiful things to the graduating class today in your acceptance speech, I guess. And I wonder if you could, I mean, you said all you need is love, but you said it
basically,
in a Cuban Canadian way, and in a quote unquote academic way. You said it to students who were going to on their way to go out and right. face God knows what in this world at this point. And I was listening to you, I thought if anyone ever needed to hear all you need is love, this generation right now needs to hear.
I totally agree with that. I can't be at all, you know, like either shy or reserved, you know, in an opportunity like this that I get an opportunity to talk to new graduates, you know, about love and about how important, because I feel that if it's not love, I would not have conquered the huge sacrifice that life has presented me with. Mm-hmm. And because of love, they haven't felt my sacrifice. And so the world that I want to see is that world, the world where people do what they do, we can call it job or work later, but do what they do because they love it. And everything else come after. Can you imagine what type of world that will, that will create for us? We'll create a very harmonious, beautiful world. Mm-hmm. And if I want my story to be understood and appreciated a certain way in the world, is that way. Is that came to Canada because of love, adjusted to Canada, let's put it that way, you know, because of love, without feeling it, because love made me not focus on what I should have not been focused, which is, oh, Canadians are this way, oh, Canadians are that way. That would have been the Alex, that would have been the Alex that came to Canada, not because of love. The Alex that came to Canada because of love didn't waste time focusing on the things that nobody should focus on.
Right.
I saw immediately the common denominator on all humanity. Culture is just the surface. Mm-hmm. Below it, everyone is the same.
Yeah. So. I think those students were really lucky to hear that speech.
Oh, thank you.
Here is a song entitled Solo Mia. Déjame esta noche estar contigo y te muestro el sol que no has podido ver. Déjame con ansias consolarte y decirte que si hay vida en Marte, ven. Déjame jugar a enamorarte, el juego donde el corazón se parte, si hay. Déjame intentar ir a buscarte, de tus propios miedos rescatarte, ven. Déjame cantarte en la mañana, para que te den más ganas de un café. Déjame dejar en tu ventana, flores frescas para perfumarla. Fe. Déjame quemar a fuego intenso esos dos recuerdos que quieres perder. Déjame llegar a donde el tiempo traiga por sorpresa un mítico placer. Busco con mis dedos entregarte al mundo, que se acorte la distancia un paso a la vez. Busco que tú sepas que en tu voz me inundo, busco mis palabras cómo hacerte comprender. Oh, Señor, Señor. Yeah. Oh, nah. Ah, yeah, yeah. Todo, yeah. Déjame esta noche estar contigo y te muestro el sol que no has podido ver. Déjame con ansias consolarte y decirte que si hay vida en Marte, ven. Busco con mis dedos entregarte al mundo, que se acorte la distancia un paso a la vez. Busco que tú sepas que en tu voz me inundo, busco en mis palabras cómo hacerte comprender que eres solo mía. Ahora una necesidad que yo no tenía, la más dulce realidad eres la manía que no quiero eliminar y nunca querría. Ya no tienes que aceptar, eres solo mía. Ahora una necesidad que yo no tenía, la más dulce realidad eres la manía que no quiero eliminar y nunca querría. Ya lo tienes que aceptar. Eres solo mía.
So, do you want to end up by telling us what's going on next for you? What are you working on now?
Oh my God, see, I'm always working on something, and now more than ever, because during the pandemic, I took one of the most incredible steps I have taken in my career, which is to record myself, to become an engineer. And I recorded an album in a corner in my living room, in the corner of my living room. Because I didn't have a studio back in Smith's. I've always been on the road. Living in the north means that if you're going to have a studio, you have to have it all set up, all well heated and stuff like that. And, you know, that's all expensive, let's just put it that way. Mm-hmm. And even more expensive if you are not going to use it. Have it and don't use it, right? So now with the pandemic, a few things turned around, I guess, in my career. And a few things, were born out of the pandemic. And my interest for producing was one of them. And so we finally took the step to making studio. I just opened up, I moved about 2 weeks ago into my brand new studio with heated floors and all that, you know, to work comfortably in the winter. But I want to split my time more now between being home producing and being on the road. But I'm always working. We are in the middle now. We just began releasing the first, we just released the first single from what is going to be an EP for me of 6 songs of this hybrid sound that, interestingly enough, I was working on at the same time that I work on the album that won the Grammy for me. For years, I've been wanting to play a little bit with electronic elements and sounds to my music. And never, for some reason, that never felt interesting to me. So with the pandemic, something started to happen to me. And so I have created this hybrid sound that at the same time maintains my identity. People know me as this organic singer-songwriter, most acoustic song. But I'm having a lot of fun with this because it still have my identity, you know, and it's freaking people out a little bit, and I love that. So we're in the middle, we are releasing single by single. The next one is coming out on the 21st. A very meaningful song, I think, is called La Bestia, The Beast. And it talks about the beast that we all have inside and how we face it and how we should not let it win. And all of that, you know, came to me through the pandemic, right? But I'm already started to work on what's coming after that EP. And I'm going to say here with all, you know, enjoyment, because it took me a while to come to this point in Canada to feel complete and satisfied with just one guitar and myself on stage. At the beginning, I thought that it's not going to be interesting for people to see this musician singing in a different language. And so I took, I guess, the steps, because I thought that maybe if I had a little rhythm session, people will hold on to that or whatever. But now I'm really loving my solo shows. People are really enjoying my solo shows. I feel very intimate. I feel that I connect more with the audience. So after this crazy electronic EP, I'm working on an entire just one guitar and one vocal album. I think I'm going to call it Una Guitarra. No, Una Voz, Una Guitarra.
Yeah. Beautiful.
So always creating something, I don't know.
Thanks for giving us something to look forward to.
Thank you very much.
And thanks for coming to the Grad Club.
This is a beautiful place. I love it. Thank you.